Like anyone who's been watching anime for long enough, I've developed a taste for shows that I know will interest me, based on their plot synopsis and genre. Naturally, there are always going to be exceptions, whether that be an anime that you thought you'd like, only to find it didn't live up to its potential, or an anime you were less sure about, managing to completely blow your expectations out of the water. But for the most part, my instincts tend to be pretty spot on. However, every now and then, I manage to stumble across an anime that completely defies my preconceptions, and if it wasn't already obvious from the title of this video, I had that experience fairly recently with an anime called Welcome to Demon School, Iruma-kun, an anime I originally had no intention of watching, as it didn't initially pique my interest, but ended up loving so much that it's now competing against one of my favourite anime comedies of all time, Monthly Girls Nozaki-kun. The story revolves around a 14-year-old boy, named after the show's title, who is sold to a demon by his irresponsible and selfish parents. Fortunately, the demon in question, known as Sullivan, merely wishes the boy to become his grandson, so that he may shower him with affection. Enrolling him in the demon school Babyls, Iruma desperately tries to keep a low profile, in fear of being eaten by his peers, should they discover that he's human. But, try as he might, he continuously finds himself in situations that only ever seem to make him stand out. Furthermore, his self-appointed grandpa is the chair demon at his new school, and wastes no time in letting everyone know that Iruma is his beloved grandchild. After being made to address the assembly, and chanting a forbidden spell in front of everyone, Iruma instantly earns a reputation he does not want, and things only escalate from there. Before the fall 2019 anime season had even started airing, Iruma-kun wasn't exactly high up on the seasonal charts, and its promotional video did very little to convince me that it was going to be something worth checking out. Just like with school babysitters though, looks can be deceiving, and thankfully there was just enough buzz and excitement around this show from those within the community for me to consider going back and giving it a fair shot once it had finished airing. It didn't take very long for me to realise that my earlier assumptions about this show were baseless, as it became clear within the first episode that this was an anime I was going to enjoy immensely, with each subsequent episode only further driving that point home. The primary reason Iruma-kun succeeds, at least in my eyes, is its stellar cast of characters. I'm what you'd call a character-driven person, in that my enjoyment of any given show is largely dependent on whether or not I like its main cast. The characters in Iruma-kun reminded me a lot of the aforementioned Monthly Girls Nozaki-kun, as well as Overlord, two of my favourite anime of all time. That last comparison might seem a little odd, given Overlord is in a completely different genre, but bear with me while I explain. Both Monthly Girls Nozaki-kun and Overlord have stellar casts of characters that not only help to carry their respective shows forward, but are also a large part of why I enjoy both of them so much. It isn't just that these characters are likeable, it's that they're instantly likeable within minutes of their introduction. It takes a special kind of anime to make me fall in love with its main cast from episode 1, and both of these anime succeeded in doing exactly that. Iruma-kun is the same, as each time a new character was introduced, I found myself immediately enthralled by them, with the exception of one particular character that I'll talk about in a minute. What's especially impressive about Iruma-kun is that it has a pretty large supporting cast, many of whom make regular appearances throughout the show, and I found the majority of them to be just as likeable as the main characters. To have such a wide diversity of reoccurring characters, and for so many of them to be this likeable, is no small feat. It also helps that Iruma-kun has a very warm and wholesome atmosphere to it, which not only ensures that the comedy remains light-hearted, but that no matter what's going on in the story, you never find yourself feeling tense or frustrated. This brings us back nicely to that one particular character I alluded to earlier. I'm going to purposely avoid showing this character, as I don't wish to spoil anyone who hasn't yet seen this magnificent anime, but let's just say there's a character who isn't quite as good as they initially lead on. Now, the idea of a good guy turning bad is hardly original, and you'll probably roll your eyes when the initial reveal is made, because it isn't at all surprising. But the way in which Iruma reacts to this revelation is what I found the most interesting, because he doesn't respond the way a typical shonen protagonist usually does in this situation. Unfortunately, I can't really say any more without spoiling that particular story arc, so I guess you'll just have to go and watch the anime to see for yourself, won't you? The point I'm trying to make is that even when Iruma-kun comes off as cliched, it still manages to find ways to delight and surprise its audience. This carries through to the world-building as well. While the anime primarily takes place in a demon high school, it's clear that some effort was put in to try and differentiate Babyls from a more traditional Japanese high school setting, with everything having appropriate demon-inspired equivalents that make more sense for its populace. What's also nice is that the characters exhibit a wide range of varied body types, and unlike most anime, this isn't strictly limited to the boys either. There are actually female characters with diverse body types. It's kind of sad that even needs to be pointed out, but far too many anime have girls falling into one of two categories, so it's nice that Iruma-kun has more than the handful of already established presets. As for the show's comedy, it's basically perfect. Obviously not everyone is going to find it equally hilarious, as we all have a different sense of humour, but I found myself chuckling and grinning so hard that my cheeks actually began to hurt after only a few episodes. There are only a handful of comedy anime I've seen that can actually get me to laugh out loud, and while Iruma-kun doesn't quite reach the same levels of hilarity as something like Asabi Asabase, the fact that it was capable of straining my cheek muscles to the point where I had to stop watching it after only 6 episodes should prove without a shadow of a doubt that this is a worthwhile comedy anime that doesn't deserve to be overlooked as much as it has. Unsurprisingly, a lot of the show's humour comes directly from its characters and how they interact with each other. Given Iruma-kun's large cast, I'm not going to talk about each and every character, but I did at least want to highlight some of my favourites. First, there's Alice, who becomes Iruma's best friend and loyal companion after being bested by him during a battle on their first day of school. Alice reminds me very much of Demiurge from Overlord, as both characters greatly overestimate their master's cunning. Naturally, in Iruma-kun this is played for laughs, as Alice always misinterprets Iruma's actions as being a part of some kind of master plan that his feeble mind couldn't possibly understand, when in reality, Iruma is just trying to avoid standing out, and failing miserably to do so. His altercations with Clara are also hilariously entertaining. Professor Caligo is easily my favourite teacher in the show. He initially has it out for Iruma due to his disdain for the chair demon's reckless abandon, and things only seem to get worse when Iruma inadvertently makes him his familiar. But despite his harsh personality, it's clear that he cares deeply for his students, and you can't help but love the guy. Similarly, Amare initially comes off as quite intimidating due to her role as the student council president, and she's among the first to realise that Iruma is a human, but she's also a massive shoujo manga fan, and when she discovers that Iruma can actually read her forbidden texts, she decides to conceal what she's learned and has him read to her instead. Amare embodies the show's wholesomeness to a T, and I always looked forward to seeing her and Iruma together. Lastly, there's Opera. He's a freaking cat boy, who made me realise that I want to see more adorable catboys in anime, as there's a serious shortage of them. Outside of his cute catboy appearance, he's also a badass who excels in everything he does, and is someone who genuinely cares deeply for Iruma's well-being. I could honestly gush about these characters for another 10 minutes, as I truly love them all, but to wrap things up, I can say with absolute confidence that Welcome to Demon School Iruma-kun is one of the best anime comedies I've seen in a long while, and I'm so glad that I went back to give it a fair shot. If, like me, you initially overlooked this anime, then I highly recommend going back and giving it a watch. You won't regret it. You can find links to legal streaming of Welcome to Demon School Iruma-kun for both the UK and the US in the description below.